गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन। गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन। लेट्स द स्टूडेंट ज्वाइन। ओके वंशिका, सो आई हैव रिटन हियर चैप्टर नंबर 6 लाइंस एंड एंगल्स फॉर टुडे। We'll wait for one more minute, then we'll start with the class. Your video should be on. Just let me know if any question comes on your screen. Again, I am repeating. Just let me know if any question comes on your screen. A question will be like, which chapter revision would you like to do? Just I'm launching it. Yeah, any question is visible on your screen, just choose one out of this. Okay, I am getting the answers. Yeah, okay, most of the students are clicking on chapter number 6. Okay, so I am ending the poll now. Is it visible? 65% has chosen chapter number 6. So we'll go with chapter number 6. Majority wins. Okay. Fine. So I have written the correct chapter name now. See, as you have given me the test recently of chapter number 8 also, so let us begin with this, or 7 also we have given. Okay, starting with this, and we'll start with the questions. I think you are able to do the other questions other than proving, so we'll revise the proving questions first, then we'll go with the other questions. There are some questions which students always ask, so we'll revise those. For example, we are starting with exercise 6.1. If you want to ask by your own, sir, this is my problem. I have practiced that earlier, but these questions are out of my mind, so you can ask those questions. Rest, I am starting with 6.1, question number 5, the proving one. Or we have other proving questions also, means all are easy. I must say the chapter is easy, but somewhere some students are having doubts in these questions, so I am taking out these questions only. The question number 5, where POQ is a line. And OR is perpendicular to PQ. I am just writing the question. And we have to prove that angle ROS is half of angle QOS minus angle POS. And a question is given here. Then it is So here comes the question PQO. If angles of quadrilateral are 90, then it is a rectangle. Koshima is asking if angles of quadrilateral are 90, then it is a rectangle. Anyone who want to give the answer, Koshima is asking in between, sir, if angles of quadrilateral are 90, then it is a rectangle. Is it so? See, first of all, there is a sequence from quadrilateral, move to parallelogram. Then, if you have proved a quadrilateral as a parallelogram, and all the angles are 90, then it is a rectangle. Yes, means process will go like this, but it can be proved as a rectangle. No problem at all. There is a question on this we have done. Where in a quadrilateral we have proved all angles 90, then we have written that opposite angles are equal, so it is a parallelogram. Then we have proved that as all angles are 90 in a parallelogram, so it is a rectangle. Okay, I'll see that also. So starting with this question, where this is R, this is P, Q, and here we have S. It is written that ROS is this in the middle. This is ROS. ROS is half of QOS minus POS. ROS is half of QOS minus POS. So here QOS is this and POS is this end. Okay, so how we can relate these three and how we can make this equation? So starting with the question, write given. And given, you have to write that OR is perpendicular to PQ. Koshima, it is true. I'll explain you this. It is true, but how to prove that? There is a procedure to prove that. Okay, yeah, I'll tell you. So OR is perpendicular to PQ, and to prove, write the same that ROS is half of angle QOS minus angle POS. Arinder sir, he is not there in waiting room. So look here, proving. Just look, go for the 90 degree angle. See, OR is perpendicular to PQ. Therefore, angle POR and angle ROQ, both are making 90 degrees. Means POR, this POR and ROQ, both are making 90 degrees. Okay, so I'm starting with this. QOS. So angle QOS can be written as angle QOS can be written as ROQ plus ROS. Yes, no, this QOS includes two angles, ROQ and ROS. So ROQ is 90 plus ROS, we don't know, and QOS also we don't know. So here we can take out the value of 90 degree, angle QOS minus angle ROS. After this, see, we have started with this QOS. With QOS, we have started as ROQ plus ROS, and we have put the value of ROQ as 90, and we have took out the value of 90 degree, that is QOS minus ROS is 90 degree. Now the next part. Now the other is here, POS. Which is the other angle? POS. I'm marking again. Which is the other angle? POS. And here, ROS. See, with QOS we have solved. Now we have to solve with ROS and POS. Now look here. This ROS and POS. And POS together. If you will add these two angles, ROS and POS, then they will make POR. This ROS and POS will make POR, and POR is 90 degree. If you are able to make these two equations, one with this QOS and the other with this, keep this in mind that first of all you have to start with QOS, then in the other the second time you have to just start with these two angles, POS and ROS. ROS and POS will make POR. Now, making this second equation from first and second, both are equal to 90 degrees. So this QOS minus angle ROS will be equal to ROS plus POS. So angle QOS minus POS, make this ROS that side, it will become ROS plus ROS. So half of QOS minus angle POS is equal to angle ROS. Hence proved. This way. Is it clear? Now, some questions are asked by Aditya Man here from Access 6.2. So questions asked by Aditya Man are, exercise 6.2, just see others if you know the question. 6.2, question number 4. 6.3 question number 6 is also asked by many. Okay, I should explain from equation 2. Prerna is asking. Prerna, look here. If you've understood the first and second equation very clearly, that is very good. Okay, and just look here. Here, this is equal to 90 degree and this is also equal to 90 degree. As both are equal to 90 degree, so we can say that this yellow marked and this yellow mark, these two are equal to each other. So I have written both equals to each other because both were equal to 90 degree. So after this, take this ROS. See this, we have ROS this side and this side. Take this ROS this side. It will become a positive ROS and bring this POS this side. It will become a negative POS. Now ROS plus ROS, 2 ROS, and take this to this side, it will become half of QOS minus POS over. That's up to you, Koshima. Clear? Very good. Now, question number 4. Okay. Let me print the same question here. Okay, so it is here in front of us. So here is the question. See, the hint is already given here, but it will not come in your exam, a hint like this. Okay. Yes, Kamal Breed. Tell me how to do this question number 4.
So we will make a line parallel to ST, that is RO.
Okay, means here. So according to Kamal Breed, there should be a line. So I'm making a line here. Okay, so let me give a name A, B. So what to do next?
Sir, now PQ is parallel to both the three lines are parallel, ST parallel, PQ parallel, AB.
Okay, these three are parallels. Okay, so as per Kamal Preet, I am just writing here. Since first of all, just write that PQ and ST are parallel to each other. And by construction, we have constructed that AB is parallel to ST. Therefore, PQ and AB and ST all are parallel to each other. So, okay, it is clear now. And one more thing, what are given in the question? Angle PQR is given 110 degree, whereas angle RST is given 130 degree. Now, the next step.
QR and SR are the transversals.
Okay. Then
angle PUR plus angle QST equals to 180.
QS or QRA? Angle PQR, you are saying angle PQR plus angle this is PQR.
Yes, sir.
And
QRS.
QRS is this. This is QRS. And what are you saying? They are making 180 degree.
Okay, ARQ.
ARQ, yes. ARQ. Now you are correct. ARQ. So these two are making 180 degree because of co-interior angles. As they are making C. I have told you, if it in a C, the lines are parallel, then the angles always make 180 degree. We call them adjacent angles also and co-interior angles also. So because of co-interior angles, PQR and QRA both are 180 degree and PQR is 110. So we can calculate QRA. And in this way, QRA can be calculated as 70 degree. So this is 70. After this,
angle TSR plus angle SRB equals to 180 degrees.
Okay, again you are using co-interior angles this side. Okay, so yes, after sir. This TSR, so angle TSR plus angle SRB is equal to 180 degrees because of again co-interior angles, and where TSR is 30 degree and SRB we don't know, so we can calculate that accordingly. It will be calculated as 50 degree. Is it clear, Aditya Man, till now? So SRB is 50. So this side is 50, this is 70. Now this is left, so by linear pair we can write all together 180 degree. Okay, now as you can write that ARB is making a straight line. ARB is a line, therefore 70 plus QRS plus 50 equals to 180 degree. 70 plus QRS plus 50 is equal to 180 degree, and QRS is equal to 180 minus 120, that is 60 degree. Sneh is asking that, sir, how AB is parallel to SC? How AB is that we have drawn. We have to write construction. Draw AB parallel to ST. That's why I have written here. AB is parallel to ST by construction. Aditya Man is saying, is it clear, sir? Aditya is asking, sir, by exterior angle property. Exterior angle property can be used if you are forming a triangle here, then only. No, here in this construction triangle is not formed, so no exterior angle property. So this is the next step. After this, ARB is a line, so these three angles together will make 180 degree and QRS is 60. Is it clear, Kamalpreet? Okay, then moving on to the next problem. Those who want to see the full solution, they can see first once. Okay. Okay, now one more question asked by Aditya Man from this exercise, same question number 6. Then we'll move on to the question number 6 of the last exercise, which is asked by many students here. So question number 6 of this exercise 6.2. There are two lines given parallel. And these are not just line in the question. In the question, they have used signs, and these are two mirrors placed parallel to each other. And the lines are shown here. It means this is the polished surface. This is the back side of your mirror. Polished. Here also it is polished, this side. Means the inside, this side, and this side is the front side of the mirror. Now the lines, the mirror name is this PQ, and here it is RS. So PQ is parallel to RS. I am writing from the question. Given mirror PQ is placed parallel to mirror RS, and rest the figure is given. So Kamal Preet is saying, okay, sir, may I tell? It's good if you know the solution. So let me explain now. To Aditya Man and others, those who are having the problems, the C ones. As PQ is parallel to RS, it is already given. So two mirrors are placed parallel to each other. And this is an incident ray, AB. Yeah, this AB is incident ray. Incident ray, you know, which falls on the mirror. Okay, and it is going like this. It falls on this mirror. This arrow, just you can leave. Now after this, after the incident ray, it will get converted into reflected ray. Fine. So if we are talking about mirror PQ, then this is incident and this is reflected ray. And reflected ray is BC and CD here. Now look at AB is incident on PQ and BC is reflected from PQ. Then BC is incident on RS, then CD is reflected ray from RS. So it goes like this, comes like this. Now, to prove AB is parallel to CD, you have to prove that this line AB is parallel to this line CD. Now, do construction. In construction, draw BM perpendicular to PQ and CN perpendicular to RS. So I'm making perpendicular lines. So this perpendicular lines will act as, who will tell me, who will complete this sentence? This perpendicular line which I have drawn on PQ will act as which ray? Aditya Jain, you're wrong. Yeah, tell me. Let me check your science knowledge. No. All are wrong. I am talking about this perpendicular line, which I have drawn on this PQ, will act as which ray? Yeah. Aditya Man has written the correct normal ray. Rest all have written wrong. Some have written incident. Some have written reflected ray. So it is all incorrect answers. So okay. I hope you have read the same in 8th also. So that's why I've asked. This, the center line is known as normal ray. Okay, it divides this full ABC angle into two parts as angle 1 and 2. And these two angles will be equal to each other because this is angle of incidence. The angle between normal ray and incident ray is angle of incidence. And angle between normal ray and reflected ray is angle of reflection. Yeah. Now angle of incidence is equal to angle of reflection. So 1 and 2 will be equal. And this side, angle 3 and angle 4 will be equal to each other. A little bit of science is used here. That's it. So proving part starts now. Since angle of incidence is equal to angle of reflection, therefore angle 1 and angle 2 are equal and angle 3 and angle 4 are equal to each other. So we can write this in the beginning. Now after this, So this is by law. This is a law of reflection. You can write here. How this is equal? Because of law of reflection, which you have studied in physics. And in 10th also, you are going to study the same. So angle of incident and angle of reflection are equal. That's why 1, 2, and 3, 4 are equal. After this, as you know that PQ is parallel to RS, since PQ is parallel to RS and BM is perpendicular to PQ and CN is perpendicular to RS. Now I am writing one statement: perpendiculars on parallel lines are parallel to each other. Means if you are making perpendiculars on parallel lines, then these perpendiculars will also be parallel to each other. It means BM is parallel to CN. If BM and CN are parallel, then you can say that this angle, see this, angle 2 and angle 3 are equal because they are making Z, alternate anterior angles. If BM and CN are parallel, then it is possible. So we can write that angle 2 and angle 3 are equal because of alternate interior angles. And you can multiply with 2 both sides. And we can write then angle 2 plus angle 2. And here we can write that angle 3 plus angle 3. So we know that angle 1 and angle 2 are equal. So in place of 1, 2, we can write 1. And in place of 3, we can write angle 4. So 1 plus 2. 1 plus 2 is ABC. So angle ABC. And 3 plus 4 is angle BCD. So angle BCD are equal. After the proving till the angles equal, see ABC and BCD are equal. Now look into the figure. Now see this. This angle full ABC and this BCD we have proved equal. Now see this. It is also making Z. But these angles are already proved equal. These angles are already proved equal. But if we see carefully, then it is also making Z. It means these are pairs of alternate interior angles. That's why. So, right. But these are pair of alternate interior angles, and hence we can say that AB is parallel to CD. Hence proved. If the angles are equal but they are making Z, it means the lines which helps in making Z, means AB and CD, will be parallel to each other. So you can note it down. Let me make it a little dark. Here is the solution in front of you. Clear, Aditya? Very good, very good. Now moving on to the last and most demanding question. It is 6.3. Do not worry, the lecture will not get over until and unless I'll explain question number 6. It is in my hand today to end the meeting. I can go for the meeting for 24 hours. So no worry for the time. We can study extra for extra hours also. So we'll take few extra minutes today. What is exercise 6.3, question number 6? Printing the question here, wait. So here is a question. In figure 6.44, the side QR code, you don't know the question, you're making emojis here. Okay, be attentive now. QR of PQR is produced to point S. Means they're talking about there is one triangle PQR. So just consider this triangle PQR. And this QR is produced till S. And after that, two bisectors have been made. One bisector of PQR, QT, and one bisector of PRS, RT. And QT and RT are meeting at point T. Okay, so you need to prove that QTR is half of QPR. QTR, this angle is half of this angle. It seems like half, but how we can prove that? Given QT and RT are bisectors of, QT is the bisector of angle PQR, and RT is the bisector of angle PRS. To prove angle QTR is half of angle QPR. Proving starts here. So you can write in this way. Since this time I am changing the little bit in as compared to the previous time, I am just changing here a little. So QT bisects angle PQR. Yes, this is given in the question that QT bisects PQR. It means this angle PQT will be equal to angle TQR. Let both be X. Let this be also X and this be also X, because these two angles are equal. Okay, fine. Now one more step. TR bisects PRS. Sorry, RT bisects angle PRS. Therefore, these two angles are also equal. PRT and TRS. So PRT and angle TRS R equals to YY. Okay, and let this be angle 1 and 2. Okay, let it be angle 1 and 2. To make it a little easy, I am saying. See this now, the next step. In triangle PQR by exterior angle property. See, in this triangle, PQR, I'm using exterior angle property. What is the exterior angle of this triangle? This. What is the exterior angle of this triangle? This, no. So exterior angle is 2y. Y plus y, 2y. And interior, x plus x, 2x. Plus, this is angle 2. Let it be first equation. And come in this triangle now. TQR. According to TQR, which is the exterior, according to TQR, exterior is only this angle, which is alone Y. And what is the interior? In this, interior is only X and 1. So X plus angle 1. Now just write. Right, put value of y in equation 1. See, y value is x plus angle 1. Just take this, see here carefully, the value of y is x plus angle 1. In place of y, we are going to put this value. So in first equation, I am writing this 2. Then what is the value of y? We have calculated here, that is x plus angle 1. And this side we have 2x. Then this side we have angle 2. Now multiply it. 2x plus twice of angle 1 is equal to 2x plus angle 2. 2x, 2x cancels out. So angle 1 is equal to this 2 will go that side, half of angle 2. And angle 1 is this QTR and that is QPR. QTR is half of angle QPR and it is proved. You can take a screenshot of the same. Yeah, this is one of the method for the question. Some students have very bad habit of not making figures. It will not help you to score full in the exam. Okay. According to the lecture time of 40 minutes, it is already over. It is 42 minutes now. So I'm ending the lecture with this. And tomorrow I will continue with the same chapter. If there exists some problems, revise chapter number 6. Okay. Revise chapter number 6. This is the only homework for today. Bye. Bye everyone. Take care.